Hey guys, what is up? Sage here with finally another review. I haven't done one in like forever, so I figured while I have the time right now and nobody's home, I'll just go ahead and do a review real fast for you guys. And this time it's actually a cosplay item instead of the figures and stuff that I used to been doing, well, not used to, but have been doing the past two or three reviews or whatever. So I figured let's take it back to my roots a little bit and do a cosplay review. A quick note that I want to say, if you guys hear any, like, chainsawing and stuff outside, we have some people cutting down the branches and stuff out there, so try to pay no attention to that. Anyway, let's get started with this. So, obviously, if you guys are fans of Naruto and Naruto Shippuden, you should know that this is young Obito Uchiha's cosplay. I've actually had this one for a while, and I've worn it to quite a few cons and stuff like that. I have my picture taken a lot. Which brings me to another point. A lot of you guys have been putting in the comments of my cosplay reviews that I should model the cosplays and stuff like that. Well, I don't have a problem with that. It's just when I'm doing these reviews, I usually just try to do them as fast as I can, so I actually have time to edit them and stuff before anybody notices. Because it's not that I'm afraid of making YouTube videos and stuff like that, it's just I don't want to be picked on by my family, if that makes any sense. But yeah, so I will try to do that more often with future cosplays. I am currently actually saving up for one, so hopefully I can get that onto the review. But I do have pictures of me in this cosplay, so I will post a picture somewhere around here. Ooh, sorry, I'm a little tired. Anyway, let's get this started. So as I said before, this is young Obito's cosplay, the blue and orange. There are some black and orange variants for some reason. Those aren't actually the colors of his cosplay, but they exist. So this is the blue and orange one. I originally didn't plan to get this one because of the short coat. I'm not a fan of the short coat. I mean, like, Trunks in Dragon Ball Z has a short coat. Obito has a short coat. Sai has a short coat. I don't like it. I'm not a fan of it, but respect for Obito, so I end up getting it anyway. But, let's get started, I guess. So, here we have just the coat. The top, we have some random metal buttons. I don't know why these exist. Like, there's nowhere for these buttons to clip in anywhere. It's just, they're just kind of stuck there for decoration. Same thing on the other side. Now, this collar does stand up all alone when you're wearing it. You'll see it in the picture that I put on here. Next we move down and we have a Velcro strap here so you can keep the coat together in one piece, at least at the top. Kind of like how Obito's coat works, like it's not exact because, you know, it's very noticeable that it's just Velcro and it doesn't go all the way around, but I mean it's still a nice feature to have it there. And we have nothing else here, it just kind of hangs open. And then we flip around to the other side. And here we have the Uchiha patch. Now, it's not the best. I mean, there's some fringing and stuff like that around here. But, I mean, it's an Uchiha patch. I mean, it's pretty basic and standard. It's not too bad. Then we go down, and then the orange design from the front and the bottom continues right to the back like it's supposed to. Then we get to the sleeves. Nothing special about the sleeves. They're about 3/4 length, so I mean it doesn't, like, it comes up to about here on your arm, is where it stops. Of course, unless you get a bigger size than you are, then it should fit you completely, but yeah. That's about where it stops. You can undo this sleeve if you wanted to make it longer, but I mean, it doesn't look that great considering all the stitching on the inside is there. But yeah, that's about it for the sleeve. So I'll go ahead and just take the jacket off and we'll talk about the undershirt part. Now this one did come with an undershirt. It's not the best undershirt in the world. Of course, a lot of these cosplay undershirts aren't. It's just a kind of a blue Under Armour shirt, if you guys are familiar with Under Armour. It has a slight turtleneck-ish type of thing, but the only issue I see with that is I understand why it's there, because a lot of the Naruto characters have a slight turtleneck, if you guys know what I'm talking about, where, like, it's skin tight, kind of like Kakashi or, well, oh gosh, that's a bad example, Gai Sensei or Rock Lee, how they have, like, those slight turtlenecks and they're skin tight, so that's what they're trying to go for here with Obito, but the issue is that this turtleneck part is too loose. The whole shirt, I think, is a little too loose and baggy for the size of the jacket that you get, so it doesn't work that well. Kind of pointless in my opinion, and I was contemplating going out and getting a blue Under Armour shirt to wear with it. That was a lot tighter, but I never did. I just stuck with the shirt that it came with. I mean, it's not too bad. I mean, it's breathable, but it's not the greatest shirt. Also, another issue is it doesn't have a tag to tell you where the front is, and it's kind of homemade. Like, you can tell by the fringing here, but there is no tag to tell you where the front or the back is, so it's a little confusing when you put it on, and after trial and error, I finally figured it out. But that's about it for the shirt. And underneath, I have the pants, so we'll go ahead and talk about that. Goodness gracious. Got a little new slip hangers. Okay, and on to the pants. I'm not gonna bother unfolding them because I'm pretty sure you guys know what normal pants look like. It's just the same color as the jacket, as you can see here. It's just it's the exact same color. The belt is a belt that I have, and the little ninja pouch thing for your shuriken is something that I bought separately. I'm not sure if I did a review on it yet, so I don't know if I haven't. You guys are interested. I have the shuriken pouch and the kunai pouch, so if you guys would like to see that, I can do that, but that's just the pants. Not too bad, just, they're kind of like, if you go to Walmart, you buy, like, cheap dress pants for, like, $12 or $20 or whatever. That's about what these are like, but they're blue. It did come with a white strip of cloth about, like, it's not too long, about a foot or two. It was supposed to go around your thigh, but I never used it. I just kind of used an ace bandage for that. So I kind of got rid of it. It was pretty cheap, and I was like, well, there's no point in having it if I'm not going to use it. And like I said, I just bought ace bandages for that. And it also did come with those cheap anime belt. I don't have that anymore either because I got rid of it, but it was like a piece of really cheap white leather with a silver Velcro buckle type thing. None of it was like actual metal, it was all just the cheap leather. If you guys have seen my Kirito cosplay, it's the exact same belt, but white. So, yeah, that's about it. So, I'll just kind of put everything together. The shirt. And the jacket. So that's about it for the Obito cosplay. If you guys have watched all my other reviews, you should have kind of seen this coming with the review of the Obito contacts, which I also did with my Tobi cosplay. And yeah, I mean, I hinted at it a few times, so I don't know if you guys actually kind of foresaw this coming, but that's about it. I do have a pair of ski goggles and all the other little accessories to go with it, so if you guys actually just want to see a video on that later of all my Obito accessories, then I can do one for you guys. But that's about it. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I also wanted to thank a lot of you guys for sticking around, and all the new subscribers, and those of you who've been constantly commenting. Which brings me to another point. If you guys have any questions about any of the stuff I buy, regarding price, where I got it, sizes, anything like that, I'll be more than happy to answer. I answer a lot of you guys, like, as soon as the comment comes up, because I just have nothing better to do. So I answer the comments as soon as possible. And if I don't answer your comment, I'm sorry, I probably just didn't get a notification. So if I don't reply, then send me a PM if it's a very important question. If YouTube still does PMs, I'm not sure on that, but yeah, feel free to leave any questions and stuff like that in the comments. And if you guys pick it up, let me know, and let me see how it looks on you guys, because you probably pull it off better than I do. I just figured that it'd be a fun character to do, since Obito is like one of my favorites, but yeah. I've been rambling for too long. Anyway, that's it, guys. Until next time. Still running.